assume that we've already got the right this one. It is major depressive disorder, so let's see, it's followed at least four out of the nine criteria for major depressive disorder, or there is severe cognitive or occupational dysfunction, and or there are suicide ideations. It's very severe. It's a major depressive disorder. So the first thing to do is to start with Sertraline. Lexapro is a new medication. side note, the motor effects that are acute are PAD, Parkinsonism, akathisia, dystonia. However, the one that is chronic long-term, that comes from chronic long-term drug use in the first generation of antipsychotics is tardive dyskinesia, very hard to reverse. And of course, neuroleptic malignant syndrome, that's going to be hard to see. You get 15, send to the ER. The other ones you might want to go with anticholinergics. The one that really first comes to my mind is benzodiazepine. Where were we at? Anxiety. So second generation antipsychotics, I remember that because you say rock the Casbah. Rock, R-O-Q. Casbah. C-A-Z. That stands for spiridone, olanzapine, quetiapine. Clozaril, which usually is saved last resort. Acetapine, which is a drug that I'm not very familiar with, but apparently used, but it's mostly in the UK. It's also used here if the patient can't take oral cerebral or oral clozaril. They'll take acetapine, so and then ziprasidone, which you know, when it comes to the symptoms and the genetic side effects, not just being sedation, but when it comes to the EPS side effects. Other drugs too are gabapentin, but again that also comes with some addiction problems and it may backfire and cause a patient to have motion sensitivity. Another one, bipolar, brain mania, we're going to have people again, second generation antipsychotics. No, I'm sorry, for depression, very, very carefully, if you have to give an SSRI, do it only for 2 weeks, okay? But if it's severe, major depressive disorder, this is bipolar depression, not bipolar depression. Bipolar depression is a little bit harder to take care of. I think that's lithium and valproic acid. Lamictal, however, is easier to titrate. During the manic phase, then you want to start. Manic phase, you want to give SGA, and then if that doesn't work, then SGA plus an adjunct lithium or valproic acid. They don't interact with each other, but they are, so not to worry about that, but they are usually in conjunction with each other. Oh, I'm sorry, bipolar depression, Seroquel, and then olanzapine. Thank you. Axiolytics, again, we'll just go with benzos, just trying to